test?
Yeah, it's a bit, last 12 months is a bit of a roller coaster for me, and managed to keep my cut top 60, so I'm quite pleased with that. So looking forward for a new season.
Mardan, you have always been the flag bearer for golf in Singapore. I'm sure there's a lot of new up and coming youngsters as well. Who do you do you foresee a bright future ahead for Singapore golf, Mardan?
Yeah, we have a few youngsters coming up, and I think about six or seven of them turning pro, and they are playing this week. So I think there is a few guys that like Quincy, Kodenshan, and Tuzi Wang, Johnson Po, Johnson Wu, or something like that. So I think there's a few guys. They just I think only about a year or a year and a half turning pro. So I think we have youngsters up and coming up. Yeah.
I think, Mardan, one last question before we open the floor to the media. You know, there's a lot of talk in Singapore, especially about the declining popularity of golf, government taking back the land for other users. What are your thoughts about this, Mardan?
Pretty sad. I'm very sad about that, because the two golf clubs that they take away is where my Jurong is where my childhood club, where I know my golf, my childhood club. And then Raffles is where I developed my golf to up to now, to become from amateur to pro golf. So the two golf club have been make a lot of help for me, and it's quite sad.
All right, let's take some questions, guys.
I just want to. This is the first season of the tournament. I just want to build up my confidence back to get my confidence and make sure I can get in the winning circle again. So I think it will take a few months to build up. But I feel good. I feel good about myself. I feel good. I have a good break for almost 3 weeks or 1 month. So, and I work a lot of things to analyze, to move forward and to make it better. So I'm very confident what I'm doing now.
Yeah, next week.
I think this course suit a good ball striker. I think you need to play and like for me, I need to have my mid and long iron very solid this week, because some of the holes is pretty long for me. But I think the ball striker is most important this week, because the green is quite firm and the fairway is very soft. So that's two different game there.
Shami, you have another question, a tough one for Mardan, right?
I'm looking at my stats on the Asian Tour last year. I think my putting stat is making me not too good last year, and my ball striking, especially on my driver, I'm used to be very consistent on my driver, but I'm not there. So I think there's two things that the main factor is, I think it's around the green. I think that's where I have to work very hard on that.
Alvin?
Young guys to actually rise up to your ranks. Yeah, I think it's a bit difficult because we don't have our domestic tour, which like Thailand, Malaysia, Philippines, they have that. So to build up players like those countries, I think you can see all the young Thais coming up, even the Malaysian, the Filipinos, all, especially the Malaysian, I think a few of them, since they have their own domestic tour, they have built up the players quite good. And the Thai boys, every year you can see all the youngsters coming up. So for Singapore, I think we need that. We need that to expose our youngsters and move to the next level.
John?
Yeah, hi, Mark. We talked about the raffles growing, closing down, or going to close down. I mean, at this tournament or so, you know, 5-6 years ago, it was $6 million. Now it's $1 million. Why do you feel that golf as a whole in Singapore has the priority for golf is sort of like is less now than it was 5-6 years ago?
I think it's for the players, the more is the better. The more the prize money is better. But I think to sustain the tournament for $6 million every year, I think it's a bit difficult. And what we start now, go back to $1 million, I think it's a good start. And from there, we can move bit by bit to make the Singapore Open exist every year. Otherwise, after the $6 million, and then we don't have the 2 years, we don't have Singapore Open, then it's quite sad. You know, it's better to keep $1 million, 1.5, and then you can do it every year, rather than you do $6 million and then you lost next 2 years. I mean, it's quite sad. Yeah, I'm looking down at my stats and to try to work out on what the thing that I need to work on for last a month. So it's just to build up my confidence and to sharpen up my putting and around the greens. See. So that's where I've been losing a lot of stroke there. So I think that's the key point for me to really focus on this on that part, so that I can make my score lower. I think most importantly to keep myself fit. That's a key important thing for me. So I think if I can keep myself fit, I think I still can complete in a normal tour or to maybe senior tour in next year. So I'm looking forward for that also. So. I mean, it's only a number, but I still need to get myself healthy and enjoy the game.
Well, and you have played in many Singapore Opens over the years. Maybe you can share with us which is your fondest memory of, is there a particular year that stood out for you here in the Sentosa?
I think my the best Singapore Open I play is in SICC Old Course. I was in contention that time and also during a fasting month. So I think that's my best Singapore Open. I finished probably at the end of the week. I finished 8th, maybe top 10. I was in contention playing the final group and not doing well on the last day, then managed to finish 10. So I think my biggest highlight, I always keep that in my mind, is of course the Singapore Masters when I won in Laguna. So that one always keep me feel get my confidence back on my game.
Any other questions for Mardan? Yeah, sure.
No, I don't need that. I just need to make my own money, then earn my living. I think I've been holding the title for maybe 20 years, 23 years. I think it's about time to have youngsters coming up. So I don't really bother about that. I mean, I just want to keep myself healthy and play my golf. And I really look forward for my senior tour.
One last question, Mada. I think away from Singapore, I think a lot of people here will be very interested as well. You won in Manila, you won in Bangladesh. How was the feeling like, I mean, winning your title away from home?
I mean, winning is always nice. It doesn't matter where you win. I think it's always feel nice when you win. I mean, even in Bangladesh, the country, like, you know, doesn't have a tournament, and then appear after tournament, and then I won the first Bangladesh Open. So I think winning is winning. I mean, it's always nice to win. It doesn't matter where you win, but it's always make yourself move to another level.
Okay, no further question. Thank you, Mardan. Good luck for this week at SMBC Singapore Open.
Thanks, guys. Thank you very much.